We welcome back into our forum this week the COO of WWE, Triple H. Welcome.
Thank you. It's good to be back.
What a month.
Incredible month.
Capped off by a successful WrestleMania 30.
Yeah. WrestleMania 30 needed to be the epic event that 30 years of WrestleMania dictated, and I think the WWE delivered on every single level possible.
Many WWE fans feel it delivered in a huge way when Daniel Bryan won the WWE World Heavyweight Championship.
Success is judged on many levels, isn't it? Yeah. You know, a lot of people will look at that as Daniel Bryan just had the biggest fluke win of his life. Other people will look at it and say Daniel Bryan proved to the world that he is everything he says he is, and that's an A-plus player. Well, if Daniel Bryan wants to be treated as an A-plus player, he's gonna get his wish.
Are you alluding to what happened on Raw Monday night when your wife, Stephanie, dressed down, berated Kane, claimed he wasn't doing his job as director of operations, and then made it clear that she was ready to unleash the monster Kane? Does Stephanie know what she's doing?
Stephanie is a tremendous motivator when it comes to talent. Does she know what she's doing? Let me put it to you this way, Cole. Sometimes the best way to control an inferno is to just let it burn everything in its path.
Let's talk about the Shield.
Let's.
What happened? I mean, for months, this trio were your go-to guys. Mm. The Hounds of Justice handled justice for the Authority. And now this. Now we're like on the verge of a world war almost.
I don't know so much about that. Look at it this way, Cole. It's inevitable sometimes that when you give somebody that much power, when you give them that much to hang their hat on, that they start to become full of themselves. The Shield had a tremendous run. Who didn't they put down in the WWE over the course of the last year? They start to feel that power. They want to test that power out. Unfortunately for them, they crossed a line and they found out what real power, not something given, something people love you for, hate you for, just power that just is, Cole. They found out what true power is, and they were humbled by it. That would be the term that I would think would stick out the most, and should for everybody, is the term humbled. And I am going to put it to the Shield that this doesn't have to go any further than it has. I want it to be known that I'm merciful, that I'm forgiving, that I'm all those things, and I will do what's best for business every time. I'm willing to forget this and put it off as them spreading their wings and trying to see what they can do, putting their hands on me. I'm willing to forget about all of that. If they want to come crawling back, groveling at my feet, and say that they are sorry, apologize to me for crossing a line, then all this can be forgiven. We can move on and business as usual. I'll give them till Friday at SmackDown. I'll address the situation again. If they haven't come back to me by then this story will have a different ending.
Many claim it's your fault for ordering the hit on the Shield by Kane and the New Age Outlaws a number of weeks ago. I just wanted to float that out there.
Many people can claim a lot of things. The truth is, they don't know the reality of the situation.
There is this reality. Monday night on Raw, for the first time in nearly 10 years, you, Batista, and Orton stood together as Evolution, one of the most incredibly devastating groups in the history of sports entertainment. Why?
This is about power.